You remember, Sully, when I promised I'd never scallop another guitar neck?
That's right, Droid, you did.
I lied.
So now you don't have a guitar.
Welcome to the party, pals. I am Droid, and I spent way too much time on that intro. Today is random project day, and I'm gonna scallop this fretboard. This is something that I have done once before. I vowed never to do it again, yet here we are. Before I get started though, a little disclaimer. I am not a luthier. I am just a guitar player who likes to do random modifications to my instruments to see what I like, what I dislike, without spending a tremendous amount of money. That means I will be doing this by hand with minimal tools. If you are going to do this and have never done it before, I would recommend practicing on a cheap neck. This one, for example, it only cost me about $40. I bought this neck specifically for these types of projects, and if I screw it up, it's not a big deal. However, I don't think I will do so. Perhaps because I've already done it and it was a success. Now that that's out of the way, let's go ahead and get started, shall we? Alright, so we're going to start with a round file. We're going to use this block of wood to create a starting line. As you can see, I didn't even bother to remove the strings. I also have not taken any sort of precautionary measures to protect the frets. I was pretty confident that I would not hit them with any files. And if I did, this neck, as I said, I purchased it for only about 40 doll hairs. So I have to do a bunch of fretwork on it anyways. So I'm really not concerned with it. Now you're going to see me switching to a slightly wider file. It's still rounded. It's like a half circle type. This is going to help me get that deep scalloped shape that I'm looking for. And this is just a very slow, laborious, long process. Lots and lots of slow wood removal. So here you can see kind of the progress thus far. Kind of see what the final product will look like. As I go, I just like to check to make sure everything's somewhat uniform. Now working towards the middle of the neck, we can switch it up to, yet again, an even wider file now. I did this over the course of 2 days, several hours per day. It's really not a pleasant process. Basically, you're just going to want to meditate while you're doing it. Maybe listen to some music. Have a few brewskis. I know I certainly did. Of course, drink responsibly. And another progress update. It's coming along nicely. And at long last, I have made it to the first fret using an even wider file. And I've also started using some sandpaper wrapped around a dowel as well. At this point, I had pretty much had enough of this project and I was ready to wrap it up. Here you can see me rounding off the edges for a nice, comfortable rolled edge. Now let's see how it sounds. Thank you. think it came out pretty good. Super smooth. Would I want it on all of my guitars? Maybe. Maybe not. I don't know. The whole point of me doing this is I like to have each of my guitars do something different. Since I got that Explorer right there, I found myself not playing this one as much. So now that I did something a little different with it, I will probably start playing it more often now, since it's the only scalloped guitar I have. You gotta watch the vibrato a little bit. You can get a little crazy with it. Gonna wrap this one up once again. I have been Droid. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please check out my music on Spotify, Apple, YouTube, etc. under Droid, J-R-O-I-D. Linktree/Droid. Links are in the description. Be sure to check out my channel for more guitar videos like this. And as always, stay safe and take care.